the patient has the head injury and the bleeding in the chest and the fracture in the chest area and the bleeding in the abdomen area also. So we have to stop the bleeding by putting the compressive bandages on the head area first, and we have to apply it over the chin area also. After that, we stop the bleeding from the abdomen area by the compressive circular bandage. After that, we will check the from the wound in the chest area. It's coming, the blood is coming with the bubbles like crackers. So we think that is it can be the open pneumothorax. So we have to do the first aid for the open pneumothorax. So first we take the small scar plastic material and put the compression on the material, and we want to plaster it all the end except one space. So during the inspiration, the air is coming through the wound, and expiration, the air is passed through that only the space where. After putting bandages, we'll transfer the patient to the hospital, the emergency department. So in the emergency department, in the admission department, we'll enter the patient's name, data, name, age, gender and address. And after that, the doctor in the emergency department suggests to take the lab instrumental tests such as blood count, biochemistry blood count, urine test, instrumental tests such as x-ray, ultrasound. Final diagnosis, we'll suspect that patient can have the open pneumothorax, head fracture, wound in the stomach area. So the plan of the treatment is then for the head injury, knee reduction, stabilization. And then for the pneumothorax, they assist thoracoscopy by inserting the tube in the pleural spaces and needle aspiration of the air in the pleural spaces, debridement and treatment of the abdominal wound in the abdominal area.
The patient has the open pneumothorax, so we have to do the first aid by closing the wound by the plastic material, by plastering the whole side but leaving the one side a small hole. And during the inspiration, the air has come through the wound, and during expiration, the air is moved by the valve. How we can check the closed pneumothorax? First, we'll do the percussion by the comparative percussion. For the one side, we'll hear the clear resonance sound, and another side, we'll hear the tympanic sound. Then we can do the palpation. We'll have the subcutaneous emphysema. We'll feel the cracker sound. Then we can hear by the by the method of auscultation, we can't hear any sounds from the chest area. In the closed pneumothorax, we can aspirate the air from the pleural cavity by inserting the cannula, and then we'll aspirate the air from the pleural cavity. We can transport the parent by this. Hospital, we'll use the big tube to aspirate the air by using the water bottle. First, we'll insert the tip of the tube inside the water level, and then we'll aspirate the air. Won't allow the air back to the chest pleural cavity. When the failed chest occurred, the fracture near the sternum area and the side of the rib, anterior and the side of the rib, it's only attached with the skin. So while during the inspiration it's come inside, and the expiration it's come outside. So it's a paroxysmal movement of the the ribs and the sternum. So we want to control by this. First, we want to attached with the surgery. We want to attach by this with this to control the movement. Then by the artificial ventilation, we'll increase the whole chest area. Getting the blood accumulated in the heart, we want to insert the needle with the tube first. Then as soon as we want to remove the needle by leaving the tube inside. Then after that we want to fix with the catheter. You want to insert the catheter. Connect with the tube. Then remove the tube. Then connect the catheter with the tube. This is a cell-linger technique.